गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ श्री टी डी कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट आई वेलकम ऑल रोटेरियंस स्टाफ स्टूडेंट्स एल्यूमिनाई स्टूडेंट्स एंड ऑल माई डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स फॉर टूडेज वेबिनार. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द फॉर द वेबिनार आई वुड लाइक टू गिव इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स. आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू कीप देयर ऑडियो एंड वीडियो ऑफ ड्यूरिंग द सेशन. आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट टू आस्क क्वेश्चंस एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन. I would like to request all participants to fill the feedback form at the end of the session. The link for the same will be provided to the participant in the chat box. All those who will fill, only those who will fill the feedback form will get the certificates on their registered mail ID. So please follow all the instructions. Firstly, I would like to introduce you all to our college, Sri D.D. Vispute College of Science, Commerce and Management. Our college was established in the year 2010. Our college always aims high by firmly grounded by the values, beliefs and culture. Our college not only focuses on academic development but overall development of the students. Our college offers courses such as BSc IT, BSc CS, BSc Biotechnology, Bachelor of Management Studies and Bachelor of Accounting and Finance. For more information, visit our college website www.tdvscm.in. Now it's time to good leaders always lead by an example. One of the great leaders is our principal. She has been honored with Vocational Excellence Service Award by Rotary Club of Panvel yesterday. Now it's time to welcome all the Rotarians. Rotary is an organization which provides service to society, whose main purpose is to bring together business and professional leaders to bring peace around the world. Now, I would like to call upon RTN Rotary.
Yes, Kiranji, I think she has invited you. There was some noise, probably you would not have heard it. Kiranji, please introduce about Rotary Club, our club.
Okay. Good morning, friends. I welcome principal of D.D. Vispute College, Mrs. Vidyaji, and all your colleagues. Today's speaker, Rotarian Vishal Kulkarni from Rotary Club of Pune University, and all students of D.D. Vispute College for today's Raila. I would like to share some information about Rotary and our club, Rotary Club of Panvel. Rotary is started in the year 1905 and is now spread in more than 200 countries and having members more than 12 lakhs of different professions. One second. Of different professions. Our club, Rotary Club of Panvel, is started in the year 1960 and currently we are having 71 cream peoples of society in our club. Here, I take this opportunity to share some projects done by our club. Firstly, our club is second oldest club in RI District 3131. We are doing Panvel Festival successfully for last 24 years. Our club has installed gas fire crematorium at New Panvel. We have constructed more than 100 toilet blocks in school under global grant project near Panvel. Currently, our club is doing eye care project under global grant amounting rupees 66 lakh. We are also doing dialysis, mammography and pap smear test at subsidized cost. Yesterday only we have conducted this camp, mammography camp, where around 60 ladies have participated. Here are some glimpses of our projects done by our club. This is a glimpse of Rotary Club, Rotary Panvel Festival, where around 2 lakh people are visiting. And amount generated from this festival is used for community needed project. these are glimpses of last year 2019 Panvel festival. We have constructed gas fired crematorium at New Panvel. This all is done through funds generated from Panvel festival. Toilet blocks. Thank you. Thank you. At last, I thank management of DD Vishpute College for giving us opportunity to conduct Raila in your college. Now I request our club youth service director, Rotarian Dr. Nikhil Manohar, to say a few words about youth exchange program, Rotrack, and start today's program. Thank you. Over to Nikhil.
Thank you, President Rotarian Kiran Parmar. So, dear all, first of all, I welcome you all for this wonderful inspirational program called as RYLA Raila. So, dear friends, whenever we are talking about the Raila, so Raila is ultimately connected to youth. So, whenever we are talking about the youth, youth means what? When there is a youth, there is the energy, there is an innovation, there is an ideas, there will be an exchange of ideas. So, when this energy, innovation and ideas are combined by guidance and inspiration, the ultimate byproduct is success. See, we may choose any of the field. We may choose medical field, we may choose academic field, we may choose music field, we may choose art field, even we may start our own business. We all are struggling hard ultimately to become a successful, what may be the field. Okay. So this is why Rotary specifically designed this program for the youth, because youth age group is such an age group where we are on the onset of this, you know, success, or where we are on the onset of this preliminary program. Okay. So this Raila is called as Rotary Youth Leadership Awards. So basically Raila is the specific design program which is designed by the Rotary. Now, what are the main, you know, why one should join the Raila? First of all, to develop your own public skills, to develop your own communication skills. Okay. At the same time, to build up your own leadership skills, because we all are leading our life in a different way in an order to become successful in our life. At the same time, to listen to the inspirational talks, because whenever we are listening to the inspirational talks, automatically it is evolving in.
We all should join.
I think Nikhil has some trouble Raila. With the internet.
Now, apart from Raila, another or one more program, whenever we are talking about, so whenever we are talking, about a Rotary, so basically specifically so they are somewhat full in their own field. Now the big question is coming out, what about for such an age group which is on the starting point of their career? So that age group is from 18 to 30, and for this Rotary specifically designed one program, or one you can say one aspect is Rotrack. So Rotrack is nothing but the age group right from 18 years of your age to 30 years of your age, where actually we need a lot of inspiration and guidance to become successful in our career. So yesterday only our club, Rotary Club of Panvel, conferred Vocational Excellence Service Award to your principal, Mrs. Vidya Mohod Madam. And during that event, we had a very much positive discussion about the starting of your own Rotary Club. Because basically already our club, Rotary Club of Panvel, is currently having two Rotary Club. One is Rotary Club of Panvel and another club is in Rotary Club of Lakshmi School of Optometry. Okay. So in the same manner, we are also, and of course your principal, she also, you know, shown positive response that definitely we will start the same Rotary Club for your own college, which will automatically helpful for your own development. Because once you start Rotary Club, you all will groom, and automatically you all are going to lead your life in a better way. So now, without wasting your time, we will begin with our Raila program. And let me tell you one thing, after going back here from the Raila, definitely you are going to have inspirational, useful memories with you, and which I'm very sure that definitely it will be helpful throughout your life. Okay. So without wasting our time much, I would like to request our President-elect Rotarian Vijay Mandali to please introduce our today's speaker for the Raila, Rotarian Vishal Kulkarni. Thank you.
Thank you, Rotarian Nikhil Manohar. Thanks for explaining the purpose of this youth service to our students of Vispute College. Certainly that would be beneficial and they would certainly consider starting a Rotaract club in their institute soon. Very good. Thank you, friends. Good morning, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce today's versatile speaker, Rotarian Vishal Kulkarni. He is also a Rotarian from our Pune University club. Vishal is one of the founder member and managing director of Faber Infinite Creative Solutions Private Limited, with operations in Asia Pacific, Africa and Middle East. He has about 20 years of rich experience with various renowned organizations. He holds master's degree in operations management, with his first degree being in production engineering. He was instrumental in organizational transformation with 100 plus clients across a range of industries, including auto industry, engineering, steel, plastics, pharmaceuticals, agriculture, tea industry, confectioneries, bakery, food products, paper products, service sector, etc. in India, Africa, and Middle East. He has a lot of professional experience with regards to business transformation, strategic and operational planning and implementation, change management, culture building, lean management, new facility design. We are truly privileged to have such an outstanding personality to present a webinar on essential elements of entrepreneurship. I welcome Rotarian Vishal to share his rich experience for the benefit of our young and aspiring entrepreneurs of DD Vispute Institution. He also has got many awards. He has been recognized as a leader for tomorrow by ET Now. He is a certified corporate director from IOD. He has received Excellence in Organizational Transformation Award from our Asian African Chamber of Commerce and Industries, 25 most trusted consultants in India by Indian Business Connect, as well as the CEO magazine. And also he has been receiving the recipient of Accelerator Award from Mahindra and Mahindra. So certainly he has great experience, which will be truly useful for all of our students, participants, everybody who wants to achieve a great success in business. So I request Rotarian Vishal Kulkarni to come on the board and start your presentation. Thank you. Vishal, you can share your screen now. I will stop my share.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you, Rotarian Vijay Mandlik, for the nice introduction. Thank you, President Kiran Parmar, for your initial words. And good morning to all the fellow Rotarians as well as my dear students. Well, first of all, let me congratulate Rotary Club of Panvel for selecting such an interesting topic where we talk about essential elements of entrepreneurship. I must say this is the topic which is a very close to my heart. Entrepreneurship is always close to my heart. And it is also the need of the hour of our nation altogether. And in these difficult times where the entire world is transforming, moving through difficult times, entrepreneurship is something which is going to help all of us. So first of all, my congratulations to Rotary Club of Panvel, their board of direct president and board of directors for selecting such an interactive session, and also the college management for arranging this Raila. Well, I must appreciate the indirect message which has been given to me by Vaishali Madam and Nikhil to make this Raila more really interesting, because Vaishali Madam in several were very said that there will be a feedback form at the end. So automatically it's a message to the speaker that you will also be giving check. So that's a good message. And of course, Nikhil, for setting the nice tone and saying that, okay, at the end of the Raila, the students will get motivated. So indirectly, he has also passed me a message that make this Raila more interesting, motivate my students. So with this clear expectations from my audience, let me begin my presentation. I'm just sharing my screen so just someone can confirm me once it is there on your screen. Is that there?
Yes, Vishal. We are able to see your screen. One moment, it is appearing. Yes, now we can see it.
Great, thanks. So, entrepreneurship, a very, very interesting topic, which is always talked upon at all levels. If you look at which level the entrepreneurship is being talked, starting from the Prime Minister of India till the lowest guy in the country, everyone talks about entrepreneurship. This is the one thread which connects all of us. Now, if you, first of all, before we go to essential elements or essential secrets of entrepreneurship, let's understand what is entrepreneurship. And this is for my students. Now, if you go to Google Guru, there are hundreds of definitions of entrepreneurship usually you'll find on Google Guru. Let me tell you my version. My version of entrepreneurship is very, very simple. Mean anyone who is doing his or her own business and employing more than one person to me is an entrepreneur. Anybody who is running his or her own business and employing more than one person is an entrepreneur, because he's not only taking care of his family, but he's taking care of many other families as well. Before I talk about entrepreneurship, let me ask one question to all the students who are here, who are in early stage of their career. How many of you want to become an entrepreneur? With this definition, understanding this definition of entrepreneurship, that someone who is running their own business and employing one or more people, feeding one or more families, is an entrepreneur. How many of you would really want to become an entrepreneur once you pass out from your college, you do your graduation or post-graduations, and then you want to start something on your own? How many of you would like to become? Either you can raise your hand or write in a chat box, whatever is convenient to you. I'm just going to wait for a couple of minutes to understand how many hands are raised and how many feedbacks I received in the chat box in terms of yes and no. Okay, I can see more and more number of hands coming up now. And also the chat box getting full. Okay, good. I'll just wait for another 30 seconds for you to raise your hand. Okay, thank you. And I can also see there are so many messages which are coming in the chat box. Now that's an interesting sign. And it's really a pleasure to see so many youth are willing to join this league called entrepreneurship. And before I talk about secret, let me share you some important facts about entrepreneurship. Today, in the world, there are total 500 million entrepreneurs, 582 million entrepreneurs, or in simple language, in Indian language, about 58.2 crore entrepreneurs are there in the world today. Tell me how much percentage of the world population is of entrepreneurs. Now, if you do a simple mathematics where you divide this number by the world population, only 7.3% of the world population belongs to entrepreneurs. So out of 100, only 7.3% of the people are the entrepreneurs. So when, for my friends, those who have just raised the hand and put their yes or no in the chat box, the time you think that I want to become an entrepreneur, you are already into this 7.3, or your journey to become this 7.3 per part of this 7.3% starts. So in other words, the day you think that I want to become an entrepreneur, you are moving from masses to classes. You are not part of that crowd of 93%, but you are the unique guys of just part of this 7.3% of the world population. So that's why I say that whenever you are talking about entrepreneurship, you are moving from being into the masses to the classes. You will be seen like a class. Because being an entrepreneur is not easy. It requires lots of courage. It requires lots of risk-taking ability. That's why you can see out of 100, only 7 people choose to become an entrepreneur. Now again, when I talk about this 7.3... When I talk about this 7.3, it includes everyone, starting from small organizations, micro, macro type of organizations, small shop owners, to small organizations, to the medium scale organizations, to the large scale organization. It includes everyone in this 7.3%. Now, let's talk about something about India, our own motherland. In India, on overall, only 4% of the entrepreneurs are in initial stages of their entrepreneurship. 7% businesses which are running in less than 3.5 years in India. They are running in less than 3.5 years. And only 5% of the businesses are having more than 42 months lifespan in India. These are the some of the very alarming numbers to me. If you add all of them, these are not very big numbers. Everything is into single digits. And that's why I call that this nation needs many more entrepreneurs. And it's always encouraging to see young guns like you who have just raised their hand wants to join this league. The day you will join your league, this league, and the day once you start your business and you complete 42 months of your business, you are a part of those 5% of the Indians. You are not part of all 100%, but you are part of that class of 5% of the Indians who have not only started on their own, but they have survived, they have grown, and they are the class of India. So guys, when you talk about entrepreneurship, feel proud that the day you will go into an entrepreneurship, you are moving from mass, you are going to a class. That's, I can say, a chaska of entrepreneurship. Moving from mass to moving from class is the first thing which an entrepreneurship gives you. Now, this person doesn't require what kind of a revenues you are earning, what kind of a money you are earning, what product services you are doing, how much is your profitability, which regions you have presence. It doesn't count anything. Just starting on your own, employing more than one person, and then surviving for 42 months takes you to the league of this 5%. Doesn't it sound interesting? Would you like to be part of that remaining 95%? Or would you like to be a part of this 5%? What's your take? Can you just put it into the chat box? I would like to make this session a bit interactive. So those who would like to be part of this 5% now, just put in your chat box yes and no, or you can even raise your hand, whatever is convenient. Great. Interesting. Thanks for the feedback. I can see the chat box is floating now with all the yes, and that's a really encouraging sign. 5%, I understand that you would like to be a part of this 5%. But guys, please understand, though it looks very attractive, it looks very promising, very encouraging, it's not easy. That's why there are only 5%. There is another survey which shows that out of 100 people who think of becoming an entrepreneur, only 10 lands up become an entrepreneur. Where does 90 go? Out of 100 who thinks that I want to become an entrepreneur, only 10 end up being an entrepreneur, and 90 lose in this path of this journey. Why this 90, we lose this 90? And that's where today's the session which has been designed is very important, where we talk about essential elements of entrepreneurship. So what I'm going to share with all of you is my experience working with more than 200 organizations across the world. I have interacted with more than 150 CEOs understood how they have run their businesses. Of course, I run my own business. So whatever I'm going to share with all of you is this experience gathered over these years of times. First and foremost secret, which I always say of entrepreneurship, is something called the craft. If you want to become part of this 5%, the first thing, get away from this copy-paste approach. Don't start something because someone else is doing it. You have to design your own entrepreneurship journey. Of course, you can get motivated. You can learn from the entrepreneurship journey of others, other successful entrepreneurs. But at the end of the day, it is your journey. And you have to design your journey. Because this journey, there will be so many ups and downs which you will be facing in this journey. So don't start entrepreneurship with an objective that, okay, this is my role model or she is my role model. So once I start my entrepreneurship journey, I will follow exactly the same footprints like him or her. Don't have that expectation. Because the ups and downs, the challenges faced by your role model versus the challenges that you might face in your entrepreneurship journey might be different. The situations might be different. The circumstances might be different. And that's where you should be the driver of your entrepreneurship journey. And that's where the craft is craftsmanship. So your entrepreneurship journey has to be unique with you only. That's the first secret. So don't expect the entrepreneurship journey that I'm going to copy the entrepreneurship journey of my role model. And I'll just do the same thing which my role model has done. Don't do that. Don't jump into that journey with this expectation, but be ready that your journey is going to be a unique journey. Though there are 582 million entrepreneurs in the world, when you start your journey, it will not be the same of those 582 million, but it will be unique to you. Once you start your entrepreneurship journey with this expectation, you will not get bothered by the surprises that will come. When I interacted with very aspiring entrepreneurs, many startups, they say that, okay, why we started? Because we wanted to be like him or her. And whenever the situation comes where his role or model has not faced that situation, suddenly they go into a shell. That's the first and foremost my learning and advice to all the students, that learn from your role models, but at the same time, be prepared that the challenges which you will face in this journey will be unique to you, and it will be you only who have to deal with those challenges, and it will be you only who have to find your own way and make your journey successful to join this league of 5%. So first layer learning for entrepreneurship is crafting. Important fact is something called as a consumer client. Here you can see the numbers. I have given only one number to all the learnings, because to me, each and every learning is equally important.
Vishal, I will mute everyone and then again you unmute yourself.
Okay, am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah, good. So, second very important element of your entrepreneurship journey, which you should always keep in mind, is someone called as a customer, client, or consumer. You will be into the business and you will be surviving in the business only because of this one element called customer, client, or consumer. irrespective of whether you are Mahindras or Tatas or a small Kirana Mal owner or Chaiwala, the business survives only because of its consumers, its customer. If customer is not there, even the large organizations cannot exist. And that's where, whenever you are starting your business, you should always have your customer on top of your mind. He or she should be your single most priority. You should not be thinking of your business, but you should be thinking of your consumer. Always. You should be always thinking, what best I can give to my consumer? What new I can give to my consumer? Because as I said, to become that 5% league, you have to survive for 42 months. And when it is a 42 months, you cannot survive those 42 months if you don't take care of your consumers. Not only taking care of consumers, but you have to always exceed the expectations of your consumer. You have to understand what your consumer wants. There are three types of needs which are already there. One is called as a stated need. Another is called as an unstated and delighter needs. Most of the organizations only take care of stated needs. What is the stated need? That something is, if I go to a restaurant and I order a food, my stated need is very simple. Whatever is written on that menu card, that I want one pav bhaji or one some rice and everything. And the guy comes and gives me, which is a good quality material, is a stated need. There are so many unstated needs, like the service which I get, the treatment which I get, is an unstated need. Now, only those business or those entrepreneurs survive who not only take care of their consumer in terms of their stated needs, but they always look for those unstated and delighter needs of their consumer. The things which will not, which as the consumer has not talked about, the things which, if it is given to him, it will be a delighter. Take an example. A pizza company ran a campaign that if the pizza is not delivered in 20 minutes, you will get a free pizza. None of the consumer has asked for it, but they came with a kind of promising statement, which is more of a delighter needs. So guys, the second secret I want to share with you, always you are not working for your business. Yeah, always remember, when you are running your business, you are not working for yourself, but you are working for your consumers. You are working to give a better and better value every day to your consumer. So value which you have given yesterday versus the value which will be given today, there should be an improvement. And you are into business, you will survive into the business, you will grow into business only because of this one factor called consumer. So be always, always loyal to your consumer. Don't ever think of cheating your consumer. If you cheat your consumer, the business will not sustain for a longer period of time. To me, the most important element of this ecosystem called entrepreneurship is called this consumer. So be loyal to your consumer. Think always about him. What best you can give to your consumer? How can you delight your consumer? And a delighted customer will help you to grow your business. It's your customer who will grow your business, and it will not be you. That's the second thing which I would like to state here. This one of the secrets, that having a consumer always on the top of the mind, always delight, thinking of how can I delight my customer, is the second essential element of the entrepreneurship. Let's go to the third and very important element. Sabse bada rupaiya. Cash is the king. Now, typically, I can see there are some guys from the accounts and finance background over here. Typically, whenever we evaluate any business, we say how much the revenue that business has earned, how much is the profitability of that business. And we say, okay, the business which is generating more profits is a successful business. Well, to some extent, it is okay. But at the end of the day, it is not the profit, but it is the cash which you are generating in the business decides the fate of your business. Let me give you one simple example. Let's say tomorrow you start your business, you are making a revenue of 10 crore, your cost is, let's say, 7 crore. So in general, you are making a profit of 3 crore, so which is a 30% profitability, which is a very, very decent profitability figures. You will say this business is very successful, isn't it? Now, but there is a catch. Out of the 10 crores of revenue, the money which you have received from your consumer is only, let's assume, is 6 crore. The 4 crore is gone into bad debts. You have given product and service to your consumer. Either they are not satisfied with your product and service, or there are some other external factors by which they are not paying you on time. So though you have made a revenue of 10 crore, the actual money which has been received in your bank account, let's assume that it is only 6 crore. Now you are land up into a situation where actually money which is there in your bank account is 6 crore, whereas the expenses which you are supposed to pay to your vendors, to your employees, to your other associates is 7 crore. This happens to a large extent with the startups. I am consulting many startups, and this happens to a large extent with the startups where they run behind the revenue, but sometimes forget about the cash. And see, when you are at the initial period of your entrepreneurship journey, where your pockets are not that deep pockets, you can't afford this situation. You can't afford a situation where you are making a revenue of 10, but receiving a cash of 6, and there is an outflow expected of 7. The business starts bleeding here. That's where, at least at the initial stages of your business, don't run behind the revenue. Run behind the cash. When I say cash, I'm not talking about cash money, but I'm talking about the actual receipt of money into your bank account. At least in these initial 36 to 42 months, once you start your business, be focused towards cash, because if there is no cash, your business will start bleeding. It will create lots of pressures on you, which most of the businesses who run, like out of those 17%, only 5% reach up to 42 months. Remaining most of the time, these 13% lose the track because of only this factor, that they don't have cash to run the business. So always have this mantra in your mind that at least in initial 36 to 42 months of your business, I call it as a cash revenue. Your cash revenue is the amount which has been actually received from your consumer and is in your bank account, should be more than your expenses. It's not your actual revenue, but your cash revenue should be more than your expenses. And if you are into that situation, then you are in a very, very healthy situation. Your business is into very healthy situation. You will not have those financial pressures on you, which will deviate you from your track. So always and always remember to focus on cash revenue in your early stages of your business. So cash, always remember this mantra. Cash will be the king for your business. Cash revenue will be the king for your business. Third, very important, and this is very important for the youngsters like you, character. Guys, the business or the organization is always known by the people who are running the organization. So you can choose Anand Mahindra or Ratan Tata, or you can choose to be a Vijay Mallya or Nirav Modi. The choice is yours. I repeat, you can choose Anand Mahindra or Ratan Tata, or you can choose to be a Vijay Mallya or Nirav Modi. All four of them are entrepreneurs. But the way you look at it, the thing, what do you
like? Anaga Matre, zara tumhala mute kara, please. Anaga Matre, please mute yourself. There is a lot of disturbance.
Thanks, Vijayji. Yeah. So choose how you'd like to be known for. And the society worship only those entrepreneurs who have demonstrated excellent characters. So always, whenever you start your entrepreneurship journey, be careful about your character. This is very, very important element of entrepreneurship. You should be living a high character life in your entrepreneurship journey. The next element, as I say, build your own class. You can see the James Bond over here. The time, even whenever we hear this word, not say one, the first thing that comes to your mind is James Bond. He's known for the class, isn't it? Similarly, and he's also known for the style. So similarly, whenever you are doing your entrepreneurship journey, do it in a style. Have your own style, do it in your own style. Whatever you do, it should have that style statement. When I say style, is not just about what you wear and how you dress yourself, how you carry yourself, but it is all about how you are running your business. And you should be running your business in a style, in a such a style that each and every person who is observing your business should notice the difference between the other people and you. You should be seen like this James Bond, having his own style. He's not a copy master. He doesn't copy anybody else's style, but over the period of year, he has developed his own style. So see that when you are running your business, have your style, have your class. Be different than others.
Shobha madam, please mute yourself. Shobha madam, I request all the participants again, please do not unmute again unless you are requested to do that.
Thank you.
Shobha madam, please mute yourself.
I request host to mute her and then it seems. Yeah. So, whatever you are doing, have your own class. Have your own class, then only your business will be seen as a different. You as an entrepreneur will be seen as a different. You will be treated like a different. So it is a class, a style, the way you run your business, the way you will carry yourself as well as your organization will separate you. Again, I repeat, will separate you from masses to a classes. So always remember, whenever you are running your business, you have to build your own class, you have to build your own style, and whatever you do, do it in style. Very important element now is challenging. Guys, look at all the best businesses, the businesses which have grown around us. Whether this is Apple, whether this is so companies like Samsung, whether it's a big organization, Oliver, the biggest food joint, what each one has done, whether it's a Facebook or LinkedIn or Twitter or all those other businesses, or nowadays there are so many online businesses which are very successful, they have challenged the status quo. They have challenged all the successful organizations. They have grown because they have not continued what is there in already existence in the society, but they challenge the way things are done. Facebook challenged the way people were interacting and networking. That's why today we have Facebook with such a huge fan followers. organizations like this Book My Show, organizations like Make My Trip. There's so many successful organizations, big giants like McDonald's or any other like Apple, Toyota, Infosys, General Motors, Microsoft. How many names can I take? One of the common thread you will see across all of them is they have challenged the way things were happening currently. They challenged the status quo. And when you challenge the status quo, the innovation appears. So when you start your business, don't start your business that, okay, there is something, a demand for this particular product. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make the same product. Of course, you will succeed. You will do a good business, but you will not do a great business. So if you want to do a great business, you want to be a, becoming a big entrepreneur, what you must be doing, identify what are the things which a society is struggling today and challenge that status quo. Come up with a business idea which is the need of today's hour. Understand the pain points of the society. Understand the pain points of your prospects, your consumers. And once you understand those pain points, challenge the status quo, come up, challenge like why this thing has to be done like this. Is there a better way to satisfy this need? Is there a better way to satisfy this need? So you should always ask this question to yourself. Whenever you see any problem, anything the people are struggling with, you should always ask this one question to yourself. Is there a better way to do this thing better? A new way. And once you get an answer to this question, you also get your business idea. And that's how most of the renowned businesses in the world have been succeed. Challenge the status quo is another important. So don't accept the things the way they are running today, but challenge each and every thing. Of course, the next part, very important part, is this entire journey. You are going to make mistakes. You are going to make mistakes. There will be so many cold shoulders which you will get. People will say, oh guy, you are not doing very well. There's so many cold responses. There are so many people who will distract you from your track of entrepreneurship. They will say, why you are becoming entrepreneurs? Look at your colleague. He has already passed out. Now working in this particular organization, earning this much amount of money. You are an entrepreneur and still you are not earning that much money. So forget, leave this entrepreneurship. Join an organization, take a good job, earn handsome amount of money. In your initial stages of your career, you are going to get such advices. Because please understand, the kind of money you will start making once you start your business, yet initial period, it will not be that great. The money grows exponentially the way your business grows. But at initial stages of your business, at initial stages of your career, you may land up. I am using very carefully the word may. It is not necessary that every time you will land up. There are certain organizations who are making good money at the start of their career itself. There are so many entrepreneurs. But you may land up to a situation that in initial stages of your entrepreneurship, the day you will pass out from your college and join this entrepreneurship league, initially you may not be making that amount of money which your colleague is making by working somewhere. And automatically a question will come to your mind that, have I made a right decision? And that's the time where you have to stick on. Don't get distracted. Because as I said, at initial stages of the business, you will not make money. But as your business will stabilize, so there is an initial phase of the business and then there is something called the growth phase. First phase of any business is called as a stabilization phase, and which is just 36 months to 42 months is a time period for a stabilization phase. Or many people say 1,000 days. There's a new concept which says that if a business is surviving for 1,000 days, it's a stable business. So at least in the initial 1,000 days, 1,000 days again talks about 3 months, 3 years, which is nothing but 36 months. So simple, remember this mantra of 1,000 days or 36 to 42 months, till 36 to 42 months, you may not be making a good amount of money as compared with your colleagues who are working somewhere. And automatically a question will come to your mind, is it the right decision where I have made? Now that's where you have to stick to your decision. Don't get distracted. And whenever such things comes to your mind, go with the first mantra which I have talked about, consumer. Think about your consumer and say, okay, can I give something more to this consumer so that he will pay me more? So whenever such thoughts will come to your mind about money, think of your consumer and think, what else can I give to my consumer so that he will pay me more, so that I will earn more? Now, if you start thinking in this particular line, whenever you are into that depression, financial depressions, think of your consumer, identify something new value addition which you will give to your consumer. When you give to new value addition to your consumer will give you more money, which will take care of these particular needs. And then once you pass this stabilization phase of your business, you will enter into a growth phase of your business. And then suddenly you will see that your business is growing in an exponential manner. It is not a linear manner which the business grows. After the stabilization phase, and if you continue to focus on giving the best value addition to your consumer, your business will go into an exponential manner, and that's also your income will also grow into that exponential manner. And soon you will see that you are much ahead of the race. The guy who was lagging in this financial race, after stabilization phase is over, in the quickest possible time, you will be ahead of the race. The only challenge here is to stick. Ignore all those cold shoulders the people will be giving to you. Stick to your thought process. Always think of your consumer. Have him on the top of your mind and think of giving better value addition to him. He will, or that consumer or customer will help you to take you out of this situation and bring into that growth phase. And in this process, you are going to make mistakes. And I always say the celebration. Whenever you make a mistake, celebrate. Don't get bothered by that mistake. In fact, celebrate your mistakes. Because that mistakes has given you a good learning, this learning which you will carry throughout your life. So guys, don't be afraid of making the mistakes, but always remember, at least for 36 months, you will be going to make lots of mistakes, and make sure that you celebrate each mistake, because that's a life learning which you have received in your initial phases of your career. Celebrate your mistakes. The only one thing remember, make new mistake every time. Don't repeat the mistake. So you will have a new celebration every time. Don't celebrate for the same mistakes again and again. But every time make a new mistake and celebrate a new mistake. The only thing you should be careful to check, am I making same mistakes again and again? If you are making same mistakes again and again, that's where from celebration, you have to go to another mode called introspection. If you are making new mistakes, celebrate. If you are making same mistakes again and again, introspect. These are the two things which should always be on the top of your mind. I already talked about craftsmen. Remove these two words from your system, control C and control V, copy and paste. Because nowadays we are into this digital era, and these are the two buttons which we always use, control C and control V. It's okay when you are preparing your reports or anything, but in your entrepreneurship life, always remember these two buttons doesn't exist, or these two commands doesn't exist. There is no copy paste command into entrepreneurship. You cannot copy paste someone else's entrepreneurship journey, or even you cannot copy paste what you did last year into this year. Whatever the strategies worked for your business in the previous years, the same strategies cannot be copy-pasted into the next year. because the situation, the outside situation, which drives the business, changes quite frequently. And this is the time since March 2020, and today we are into March 2021, we have seen what kind of a volatility was there outside. That's the biggest learning. I say that this is a golden learning, which I'm sure all of you had. So whether it's your entrepreneurship journey or the way your organization will be growing over the period of time, remove this copy-paste approach. Every time you have to think of something new to grow your organization. So always remember, copy-paste doesn't exist for entrepreneurs. Command of copy and paste doesn't exist for entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs every time innovate. They come up with something new, they always innovate, they don't do copy paste. Very important thing, compliment. Please understand, to run any business, there's so many skills which are required. In order to run the business, you have to do some R&D, research and development of your product and service. You have to develop your product and service. You have to manage the operations of your product and service. You have to sell the product and service. You have to create your brand into the market. You have to manage the finances. You have to manage the people, that is the HR domain. You have to manage the legal aspects. So there are so many things you have to manage. And each and everything requires specialized skills. And none of the individual can have those skills. So the best way you can make your business succeed is by complementing. The photographs which you can see on your slides are my two partners, Akash and Jalay, who are my business partners. So identify your partners who will complement you. Like, you have your own strengths and your own weaknesses. So your weakness should be your partner's strength. Don't have your partners having the same strength and same weaknesses. Then it will result into a conflict. So choose your partners, business partners, wisely. And the mantra for choosing your business partners, have your SWOT analysis: strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Your strengths should be the weakness of your partner, and your weakness should be the strength of your partner. This is the right combination of a partnership. Your business will succeed, your partnership will succeed over the period of time only when these things get complemented and not conflict. If both you and your partners have same strength and same weaknesses, it will result into a conflict. But if your strengths and weaknesses of your partners are complementing each other, it will result into a success. So choose your partners wisely. Make sure that you are complementing each other and not conflicting with each other. Sometimes you may think that, okay, I may not have the partners, but I want to run on my own. I want to be only single person entrepreneur. That's fine. But when you are going to do a single person entrepreneurship journey, then you have to build a team under you who will complement. If you are good into the sales, you should hire a finance guy who is better than you in the finance. If you are good into the sales, you should hire a operations guy who can manage operations better than you in your organizations. If you are good into the operations or finance, choose a sales guy who is better than you into the sales. So identify your strength, identify the area where you are good at, and all other areas which are might be the areas I will call as your weakness areas, you have to recruit a guy who is not only equal to you, but he or she is superior to you. you will succeed only when you have this kind of a structures in place. Otherwise, I always recommend at initial stages of your entrepreneurship journey, go with the right partners, go with the people who will be complementing each other. Well, I'm sure you know all these two gentlemen. Do you know who are they? Can you just type in your chat box who are these guys? Who are these two guys? Let me give you one hint. These are the guys who have first climbed Mount Everest. Who are those? These. The guy who has climbed the Mount Everest for the first time. He's Sir Edmund Hillary. He is the guy who climbed actually the Mount Everest for the first time. Now, there's a famous story about this guy. Sir Edmund Hillary, it was not his first attempt when he climbed the Mount Everest. He had multiple attempts, so he tried, but he failed. He has to again return to his base camp. So he had done multiple attempts. And then on one particular attempt, he succeeded. And then once he came back from the Mount Everest, there was a press conference. And one of the journalists asked Sir Hillary that, okay, sir, what was your motivation? What was your motivation towards this grand success? He gave a very nice answer. He said that, I'm sure you all know this was not my first attempt where I succeeded. I did multiple attempts. So one fine evening, he said that, okay, there is something written on the chat, and Tenzing Norway. Yes, Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norway. Yes, yeah. So he said after one of the unsuccessful attempts, I came back to my base camp. I was thinking on why I am failing. And suddenly some thought came to his mind. He came out of his tent. He came out. He looked at Mount Everest and he actually shouted on Mount Everest. He says, and what word he said that, hey, Mount Everest, one day I will conquer you. One day I will conquer you because as a mountain, you cannot grow. But as a human being, I have infinite power to grow. He screamed at Mount Everest that, Mount Everest, I will conquer you at one day because as a mountain, you have cannot grow. But as a human being, I have infinite power to grow. And with my infinite power, I will conquer you one day. Now, guys, that's the biggest mantra which this guy has given to all of us. We all have that infinite power to grow. The only thing what we need is to choose right Mount Everest. Mount Everest is nothing but the goalpost. The goal which you will choose. So carefully, be very, very careful in choosing your Mount Everest. That's why in my previous discussion also I said, challenge the status quo. So which status quo are you challenging? Which Mount Everest are you challenging? Here in his case, the challenging the status quo was nobody could ever climb Mount Everest. So that was thing which was there in the mind that, okay, Mount Everest is the biggest mountain in the world. Nobody can even reach to the peak of it. These two guys challenged this status quo. And today they are known for what they did. So guys, here very important is, what is your Mount Everest? Very, very important. Your goal, you should choose very, very carefully. You will become big as your goal. So if you chose a small goal, you will remain small. But if you chose a big goal, if your goal is like that Mount Everest goal, you will become big. If you want to become big, challenge big. If you want to remain small, challenge small. That's your choice. So, but the very important point here is choose your Mount Everest correctly, because it's your Mount Everest or it's your goal which is going to write your destiny. So choose your goals very, very correctly. Give a good amount of introspection, good thought process while choosing your goal. And last and not the least, of course, there is one more thing which I will say. Guys, this is your film. This is your film. Make it large. Don't confine to a small film. Don't make a documentary. Make an Oscar winning film. This life journey of entrepreneurship is your film, is nobody else's film. It is your film. You are the director, you are the actor, you are a producer, you are a musician of this film. Make a big film, make a large film. Make a film with an Oscar in mind and not a small award in mind. It's your film, make it large. As I said, you are the director of this show. It's everything is in your hand. Nobody can take away it from you. Be focused, be attentive, set those large goals. Have your consumer always on the top of your mind. Always keep challenging the status quo. Always remember that initial period, cash is the king. Choose your Mount Everest correctly. Build non-touchable, untouchable character. And that's how you can make large film. And this in entire process, don't forget this very important element called care. While running your entrepreneurship, of course, entrepreneurship is all about business. Business is all about money. Business is all about profit, loss, cash in the accounts, cash in the pockets. Yes, of course, that is the sole purpose of the business. But in the entire process, do care for your society. I am a Rotarian, and we have our fellow Rotarians over here who are also their successful entrepreneurs in their respective field. Why we are together, why we are connected today, and this is not about a couple of clubs, but we are connected as a globally today, because all of us do think of this important value called care. It's a society who is helping your business to grow. So that's where, what are the scale of entrepreneur you will be tomorrow? Always remember to care for your society. You have to give back to your society. The society is giving to you. You have to give back to your society. So always remember, care for your society. Succeed in your entrepreneurship journey. But at the same time, always keep remembering that you owe something back to the society. So don't forget this value of caring for your society. So I think I am getting exhausted with the time given to me. So I will take a pause by sharing this last sentence that never forget, only fish swims with the stream. And we are not the fish. Let's flow against the stream. Think of that 7% or 5%. Think that from masses go to classes. And I really would like to eager to see if this helps you for your entrepreneurship journey, if at all it will help you in the future, to share some of your interesting success stories with me, which will make me also happy. With this, once again, thank to Rotary Club of Panvel, the college management authorities, as well as all the students who are patiently listening to these talks. I'm sure the expectations which were set, at least you can go away with one or two important things. And I would really look forward to seeing many entrepreneurs joining this league called entrepreneurship. Thank you very much, and my best wishes to all of you. Thank you. I'll be open for any question answers if anyone has.
Yes, students, any questions? If you have any questions, you can unmute yourself and ask one by one. Okay. I think no one has any questions. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. thank you for wonderful session and explaining and sharing with us secret of successful entrepreneur. Now I would like to call upon Dr. Nikhil Manohar, Youth Service Director, to felicitate our college alumni who are successful entrepreneurs.
Nikhil, Dr. Nikhil would explain about the purpose of this RILA Awards and then we will present.
Okay, thank you.
Nikhil?
Hello.
Yes, Nikhil.
Thank you, Vishal sir, for your wonderful motivational talk. Specifically, thanks a lot for telling the exact difference between the inspiration and copy paste. And at the same time, thanks for giving two important messages. Have some patience and change your life from mass to class. So I'm pretty convinced that and I'm very sure that all the students are going to keep these three important guidelines in their mind throughout their life. And definitely it will be helpful for them to build their career as a successful entrepreneur. Now, thank you, sir, once again. Now, Rotary always understands the importance of the youth. And in an order to encourage young entrepreneurs, always Rotary is conferring RILA awards to the successful young entrepreneurs. So Rotary Club of Panvel would like, so Rotary Club of Panvel already recognized three young entrepreneurs from your own college. So for this, I would like to request Rotary and Vijay Mandli to proceed further to confer these RILA awards to awardees. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nikhil. As Dr. Nikhil said that we would certainly like to encourage the students who have achieved a great success or they are on the way of achieving great success in their own entrepreneurship and they are all your students. They were your students from your college. The first one is Abhishek Mahendra Patil. He is the proprietor or coordinator of Dev Corporation. His company profile is he has established it in August 2015. And all government e-services like online certificate licenses through Common Service Center, Setu Kendra. And I'm sure there are many services like Sarkari Dakhle, Parwane, Affidavits, Registration, PAN card. So he's touching on the different services. And again, I'm sure, as Vishal said, that he is also focusing on the customer as a prime motive of this business, right? So his educational qualification is graduation in BMS and he's pursuing MMS or MBA, right? So we are very happy to announce this Rotary Youth Leadership Award to Abhishek Patil for demonstrating qualities of a young entrepreneur. Congratulations, Abhishek Patil. This is the certificate for you. Abhishek is here. Abhishek Patil has joined.
Yes, sir. I'm joined, sir.
Yeah. Would you like to
talk
a few things about your college and your days of college? And
I'm thankful to every teachers and principal ma'am and every staff that motivate me and inspire me to be a good entrepreneur. And they help me in every opportunity to grab that opportunity and be at this stage. And I'm thankful to all our teacher staff and my college to be this great meet at achieve this level.
Very good, Abhishek. Congratulations and keep it up. We wish you all the great success in future.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Then the next recipient of this award is Nilesh Sawant. Okay, Nilesh Sawant is a business owner of or self-employed company that is Neil's Tech and Consultancy. It is into web design and development company. Educational qualification is Master of Business Administration in Information Technology. So we are very happy to award this to Nilesh Sawant for demonstrating qualities of a young entrepreneur. Congratulations, Nilesh. You are there. Is Nilesh Sawant around? I think he's there. I saw him before a while. Yeah, Nilesh, would you like to speak? Maine aapko unmute kar diya hai. Okay, I think Nilesh is not able to.
Hello.
Yeah, Nilesh.
I was another call. This is the life of entrepreneurship. I'm really thankful for everybody for supporting me in the college also. I remember my first principal, who was Ramesh Pulgaonkar sir. He supported me when I was doing job at the time of the college. And he gave a lot of management insights. He was from the management background. So I am really thankful for the college for actually supporting that insight and actually also supporting me with the first project of the college. I did the website of the college itself. That was my first solo project, which I did.
Okay. So great. Very good. So congratulations to you, Nilesh, and congratulations to the college. You are developing your own entrepreneurs in whatever ways you can throughout their education. That's a wonderful thing. Third recipient is Pradeep Sonavne. Pradeep is a proprietor of E-Trade Enterprises. His company is into e-commerce and he has a qualification in BSc IT. So very good, Pradeep Sonavne. We are awarding you this for demonstrating qualities of a young entrepreneur. Congratulations. Are you there, Pradeep? Is Pradeep there on the call?
Yes.
I think he is not there. But anyway, so we wish you a great success in your future. Thank you so much and congratulations to all the recipients. Yeah. So I request our secretary, Rotarian Shirish Nandedkar, to give a formal vote of thanks from behalf of our club.
A very good afternoon to all. First of all, let me first thank Mr. Vishal Kulkarni, Rotarian, who has really had an excellent talk on the subject of elements of entrepreneurship. It was really a very absorbing session, which was fully supported with lots of examples, great ideas, and tips for all these young entrepreneurs. I should say that all the students who are now on the way to becoming great entrepreneurs must have kept important things what Vishal has already given us. So, and they can always become successful entrepreneurship. So, thank you, Vishal, for such an excellent talk. And it was really a nice eye-opening session for all the people. A very motivating and inspirational talk. I'm also thankful to Rotarian Vishnukant Matre, District Raila Chair, who was instrumental in getting nice. I'm thankful to DD Vispute College of Science, Commerce and Management, New Panvel, Coordinator Mrs. Vaishali Chandranama, and Principal Mrs. Vidya Mohan, who has also been awarded for the yesterday by Rotary Club. I am also thankful to all the students and staff of Vispute College for attending in great numbers, making this program a success, and also all the IT support staff for the proper coordination of today's program. Also thank all the Rotarians for the full support and making this program a success. Thank you all. Over to you, Vijay.
Thanks, Shirish. Now it is over to Mrs. Vaishali Chandarana for the concluding session of today's webinar. Thank Vaishali, madam, over to you.
Yes. On behalf of Sri D.D. Vispute College of Science, Commerce and Management, now I would like to express gratitude towards all the Rotarians, our principal, our team members, Professor Trupti Thakur, Professor Tirtha Malwari, Professor Neeraj Bharambe, Professor Swapnali Jadhav, Professor Kirti Chikodi, Professor Yogita Patil, Professor Tirti Patil, for constant support and work. I thank all the Rotarians, all the staff, teaching and non-teaching staff. I thank all the participants of today's webinar and alumni students. Thank you all. With the due permission, now could we end the session?
Yes, thanks everyone, and it was a great learning with Vishal's presentation here, and I'm sure it will make some change in everybody's life. All the students must have picked up, and we wish you all the best in all your endeavors for future. Okay, thanks Vishal, thanks once again, and see you later on different webinars. Okay, and as we mentioned in the beginning, that we would certainly like to start a Rotaract club in your institution, so that our interaction would go in a more structured way and more frequent manner, so that it would be beneficial for the students. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks everyone. Kiran, you would like to add something before we end the call?
Thanks to all participants. Thank you Vishalji for your wonderful talk. Thank you.
I request all the participants to please fill the feedback form at the end in the chat box now. Yes. Already provided you in the chat box. Thank you everyone.
Okay. Bye-bye. See you all. Have a nice weekend.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Bye.